Hello everyone, and now we are going to discuss the next section, that is CAM terminology. Already in the last sections we have completed the classifications of the CAM and the follower. Now this is CAM terminology, means the terms that is going to be used in the CAM and the follower. We will see one by one. Okay, you can see this is the diagram of the CAM and follower. Okay, different types of angles, different types of profile, different types of circles, you can see easily visibles are there, and we will see one by one what it is. First I am going to consider the base circle, because it is an important circle of the CAM. Okay, so what is base circle? When you see the diagram, you will be able to understand where is the base circle. Okay, this is your base circle. Okay, you can see in the diagram, this is your base circle. This is the minimum radius circle of the CAM. What I am going to say, see, for example, this is your CAM, okay, and this is your center of rotation of the CAM. This is your center of rotation about which the CAM is going to be rotated. Similarly, this is your CAM center, and where is the CAM? CAM is here. Let me show you where is the CAM. This is your CAM profile. This is your CAM profile. This is your CAM profile. Okay, carefully see. This is your CAM profile. Are you able to understand? Okay, this is your actual CAM profile like that. Okay, now what is the base circle? This is the minimum radius circle of the CAM, which can be drawn from the center of rotation of the CAM. Now it is going to be hinged here. Okay, so this would be the center of rotation of the CAM. So by taking the radius up to the minimum radius, this is the minimum radius. You can see, if you consider this radius, this would be greater, this would be the greater. So when you see minimum radius of the CAM profile from the center of rotation of the CAM, you will get this. Okay, so by taking the radius equal to this distance, you need to draw the circle. So when you draw the circle, you will get the base circle. So what is the definition of the base circle? This is the minimum radius circle of the CAM from the center of rotation of the CAM, which touches the CAM profile. Is it clear? Which touches the CAM profile. Again, I'm going to explain you what is a base circle. Base circle, that means this is the circle you must have to draw by considering the radius. And what is this radius? Base circle radius is what? When you move from the center of rotation of the CAM up to the CAM profile, suppose you are going from here to here, you will get 10 meter. For example, 10 meter you are getting. When you go from here to here, you will get 15 meter. When you go from here to here, this is the CAM profile, you will get 2 meter, for example. Okay, all the radius are greater than 2 meter. So this is the minimum radius up to the CAM profile from the center of rotation of the CAM. So this radius would be the base circle radius, and the circle drawn by taking radius equal to this, you will have to draw base circle. Is it clear to everyone? So again, I'm saying that this is the minimum radius circle of the CAM. Okay, so let me write here. Each and every term you need to understand. Don't try to learn directly. Just understand through the diagram. Okay, so let me write here. It is minimum radius circle of the CAM. This is the minimum radius circle of CAM. Directly questions come from theoretical portions of this CAM. They will ask you what is the minimum radius circle of the CAM. You need to know this is base circle radius. Okay, from the center of rotation of the CAM. If you are preparing for engineering service examinations, they will ask you theoretical questions, which might be confusing here. You will see when we discuss about the, you know, CAM terminologies, remaining time circle, pitch curve, and the pitch circle radius, time circle. So now then you will get confused after that. Okay, initially you are going to understand what is happening here, but later you will get confused among the pitch circle radius and the base circle radius. So just focus on the diagram. Okay, if you learn the diagram accurately, you will be able to define each and every terms accurately. Okay, so this is the minimum radius circle of the CAM from the center of rotation of CAM which touches the game profile, which touches the game profile. It will not cross the game profile. Okay, it will just touch. Okay, so you have to consider the radius, which is minimum. Okay, and this circle must touches the game profile. It will not cut the game profile. Okay, so which touches the game profile. Is that clear? And the radius is known as the minimum radius of the game. This is the radius is known as minimum radius of game. Minimum radius of game. Okay. So this is the minimum radius of the game. And one more thing that you must understand, this is one of the most important specification of the game. Okay. This is the most important. Why it is most important? This is most important specification of the game. Most important specification of the game, because when you go to the shop to purchase the game, you just have to tell them the size of the game. Okay. How can you tell them? You just have to let them know what is the diameter of the base circle. So that means the size of any game is specified by the diameter of the base circle. Size of any game is specified by diameter of base circuit. Is that clear? So this is the important point you must understand. Size of any game is specified by the diameter of the base circuit. This is an important line. Okay, and where is the base circle? This is your base circle. This is your base circle. Okay, which is having the minimum radius of the game, which touches the game profile. Okay, this is the minimum radius of the game. Okay, this is your base circle. I hope you will understand this base circle accurately. Now come to the second terminology, that is trace point and the pitch curve. Now trace point is not the point on the game. This is the point on the follower. Okay. Where is the follower? This is your follower. This is your follower. Now what you need to do in order to find out the trace point and the pitch curve, you just have to revolve this follower around the game profile. Okay. Hold this follower and just revolve this around the periphery of the game. So when you revolve this follower around the periphery of the game, the profile you will get would be this. This profile you will get. Let me draw the profile you will get after revolving the follower around the game profile. Game profile I am saying. This is your game profile. So you will get this would be your profile you will get when you revolve the follower around the periphery of the game. Okay, so what is the trace point? First you need to understand the point on the follower which is required to trace the game profile is known as the trace point. Is that clear or not? Are you getting my point? This is not the point on the game, this is the point on the follower. Okay, so this is your trace point, you can consider like that. Okay, and the curve traced by, now you are seeing here there is a curve which is traced by the follower when you revolve this follower around the periphery of the game. So what is this curve? This curve is known as the pitch curve. See, when you revolve this follower around the game, your game must be in a stationary condition. Okay, only follower is revolving around it. Okay, so the curve traced by trace point by keeping the game stationary and revolving the follower around it is known as the pitch curve. Is that clear? So this is your pitch curve. Okay. Again, I am saying what is pitch curve. The curve traced by the trace point by keeping the chemistry stationary and revolving the follower around it is known as the pitch curve. Okay. So let me write here what is trace point and what is pitch point. So the point on the follower, the point on the follower which is required to trace the, what you are tracing, you are tracing the chem profile, which is required to trace the chem profile, is known as trace point. And what is the pitch curve? See, in the gear chapter, you see the pitch curve is important circle because the size of the any gear is specified by the diameter of the or the radius of the pitch circle. But here, in case of cam and follower, the most important circle or the size of any cam is specified by the base circle. Okay, base circle diameter or base circle radius. Okay, so this is the pitch curve. So the curve traced by trace point. We focus on the diagram. Curve traced by the trace point by keeping the chem stationary. And revolving the follower around it is known as pitch curve. Is that clear to everyone? What is trace point and what is pitch curve? So pitch curve and trace point are related to each other. So this is pitch curve. Once you are able to understand the diagram, you will be able to define the terminology. Okay, you will not get confused. Okay, so try to learn this terminology through the diagram, then it would be easy to understand. Now the next is prime circle. What is prime circle? What we have done in the last terminology, we have considered the trace point on the follower and by keeping the chem stationary and revolving the follower around it is, we have traced the pitch curve. Okay. So once you get the pitch curve, you will get the prime circle. Remember that first you need to draw the pitch curve, then you can get the prime circle. How can you get? Again, the same condition. You have to consider the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve, which touches the pitch curve, like we have drawn the base circle. Similarly, we have to draw the prime circle. But here, in case of prime circle, you have to consider the minimum radius circle. You have to consider the minimum radius from the center of rotation up to the pitch curve. Okay. This time, you have not to consider the chem profile. You have to consider the radius up to the pitch curve. But this radius must be the minimum radius. Okay. So what I'm going to say, it is the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve. Okay, because once you get the radius, minimum radius, you have to draw the circle. Okay, so this is the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve, which touches the pitch curve. Again, I'm explaining through the same procedure. Suppose you are going to consider this radius. This is also the pitch curve. This is also the pitch curve. So this radius is suppose 10. You have considered this radius. This is also the radius up to the pitch curve, which touches the pitch curve. Okay, so let us consider this is 20. Now similarly, you will get the minimum radius. This is R minimum. Okay, but this R minimum is the radius up to the pitch curve, which touches the pitch curve. Okay, so once you get the minimum radius of the pitch curve, then you will have to draw the circle around it. Is then you will get the prime circle. So what is the prime circle definition? See, it is easy to understand this terminology through the diagram, and this is hard to learn directly without diagram. So just focus on the diagram what I am going to draw here, then you will be able to understand what is the prime circle. This is your prime circle. This would be your prime circle by taking the minimum radius of the pitch curve from the center of rotation of the cam. Okay. This is the minimum radius. The prime circle I am going to write down here. This is the minimum radius circle. Minimum radius circle of pitch curve. Of pitch curve which touches the cam profile, which just touches the pitch curve. Okay, so what is the confusion? The confusion is there that in the examination they will ask you the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve. So the options will be there: pitch circle, prime circle, base circle, like that. And if you don't know what is the prime circle, you can choose prime circle as the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve. But you need to understand through the diagram that the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve is not the pitch circle. This is the prime circle. Okay, the many questions have been asked in the examinations on this point too, because the confusion is there. And students think that minimum radius circle of the pitch curve is pitch circle. No, this is not true in case of cam. In the gear, you can say minimum radius circle of the gear can be considered as a pitch circle radius, but here in case of a cam and follower, the minimum radius circle of the pitch curve is the prime circle. Okay, you can see in the diagram. Now what is the pressure angle? This is very simple, the angle between the line of action and the, see, this is the line of action. What it is line of action? This is your line of action, like that. This is your line of action also. Okay, this is your line of action. The angle between the line of action and the, which is the common normal at the point of contact, and the line of motion of the follower. Line of action is also known as the common normal at the point of contact. Okay, this is your point of contact and this is line of action, which is also known as the, you can say this is the common normal at point of contact. Okay, so what is the pressure angle? You can see here, this is your pressure angle. Okay, you can denote it as phi. So it is the angle between, this is the angle between the line of action, it is the angle between the line of action, which is the common normal, which is the common normal at point of contact, at point of contact, and line of motion of follower, line of motion of follower. Okay, is that clear? Now the third and last is pitch point and the pitch curve. This is the last analogy. Now what is pitch point and pitch curve? See, we have seen in the previous terminology, we have seen the pitch curve, but we have not considered the pitch point. So again, I'm going to show you what is the pitch point and how it is related to pitch curve. Okay, we have seen that the trace point and pitch curve relations, that the trace point is the point on the follower. Okay, by taking that point, we have to revolve the follower around the cam profile, and the curve traced by the trace point is known as the pitch curve. So this is how pitch curve is related to trace point. But what is the pitch point? This is not like a trace point. The pitch point is that the point on the pitch curve. Again, I am saying each term should be noticed. The point on the, first I am going to write, then I will show you in the diagram. The point on, the point on the pitch curve where the point on the pitch curve where the pressure angle phi is maximum. The point on the pitch curve where the pressure angle is maximum is known as pitch point. Is known as, once you get the pitch point, you just have to consider the distance from the pitch point to the center of rotation of the cam, and this distance is considered as radius, and by taking this radius you just have to draw the circle and you will get the pitch circle. Is that clear? Here I'm going to show you the, this is pitch circle. Okay, this is pitch circle. So the point on the pitch curve, again I'm saying that the point on the pitch curve, let us consider your follower is here. Okay, so this is your, here the phi angle is zero, but here you can see when the follower is this, at this position, the line of action of the follower, the line of motion of follower is this, and the line of action is this. Okay, so angle between them is considered as the pressure angle. So when this pressure angle can maximum, when at this point the pressure angle can be maximum. Is that clear? At this point the pressure angle can be maximum. So this is the point on the pitch curve. This is the point on the pitch curve. Remember that this is the point on the pitch curve. Okay, this is the point on the pitch curve, is known as pitch point. Okay, here the phi is maximum according to the situation. Phi is maximum. You just have to know that the point on the pitch curve where the pressure angle is maximum, wherever the pressure angle is maximum, we just have to consider the pitch point there. Okay, so is known as the pitch point. So the point on the pitch curve, what is the important thing is here, this is the point on the pitch curve where the pressure angle is maximum, where the pressure angle is maximum, is known as pitch point. Now, and the circle drawn from the center of rotation of the cam, what you have to do, the circle drawn from the center of rotation of the cam having the radius equal to the distance between the pitch point and the center of rotation of the cam, you just have to draw the circle. Once you have to draw the circle, you will get this circle. This is the circle you will get. Okay, and this is known as the pitch circle. This circle and this circle is known as the pitch circle. Its circle. Okay, because you have considered the radius equal to the distance between the center rotation of the cam and the pitch point. Pitch point is what? The point on the pitch curve where the pressure angle is maximum. So the radius, consider the radius and you just have to draw the circle and you will get the pitch circle. This is your pitch circle. This is your pitch circle. Okay, so what is the pitch circle? Circle drawn from the center of rotation. See, this is not the center of the pitch circle. This is not the center of the cam profile. This is not the center of the base circle. This is the center of the cam profile. Okay. Cam profile would be like that. So this is not the center like that. This would be the center of rotation of the cam. Okay. So the circle drawn from the center of rotation. Center of rotation of cam. Having a radius equal to distance between center of rotation of cam, pitch point. Once you draw the circle, this circle is known as pitch circle. Is that clear? So these are the terminology of the cam. It will be easy to understand once you go through the diagram. Okay, so just to try to learn this terminology using the diagram, otherwise you will get confused. But if you are able to understand the diagram properly, there will not be any confusions. Okay, so I hope you will understand this whole procedures. So thank you.